Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome back to another video on Next.js. In this video, we are going to play with images. First, we will see how to display an image from local storage. Then we will display an image using an online link. Then at last, we will see how to mask an image. I am using the latest Next.js 13. Feel free to share your thoughts in the comment section. Without wasting more time, let's get started. This is what we are going to build. The first image will be from local storage. And the second one will be from a link. This is called image masking. I started a Next.js app and these are my default settings for this project. Next, I opened the app in Visual Studio Code, but before writing any code, let's run this project using the command npm run dev. Okay, this is the default rendering of the Next.js app. Now if you go to the page.js file which is inside the app directory, you will find the default code of Next.js. This is the code of what we saw just now in the browser. But we are going to delete this code because we have to do something different. First, add a header with a h1 tag. We will style it a bit. We are using the Tailwind CSS in this project. I am not good at CSS, so feel free to correct me. To display the image, we have to use the image component. It's already imported, so we don't have to import it. The image component required a source property. For this, make a directory inside the public folder and name the newly created directory as images. Now inside the images folder, add your images files. You can see my project structure for more clear idea. The ALT attribute in Next.js is used to describe an image for screen readers and search engines. It also acts as a fallback text if images are disabled or an error occurs while loading the image. Okay, the image is not displaying because I wrote the wrong extension of the image file name. Okay, perfect. It's working great. Now let's add one more image from an online link source. We want to place this image side by side of the existing image, so we will add a div element and set the flex property to row. Inside the div, we will add two div elements, one for each image. This is my GitHub profile and I want to display my GitHub profile picture here. So copy this link and paste it into our code. Then add ALT text height and width. Now if you save and check the browser, you will see an error. If you read the error carefully, it says that you need to configure the next.config.js file. They have provided a link, so click on it and find out what we need to do. You need to copy the code from the link and paste it into the next.config.js file. You need to modify the copied code according to your requirements. For example, if you are using a GitHub profile picture, you need to modify the host name and add the relevant hostname, which in this case is avatars.githubusercontent.com. After you have modified the next.config.js file, your localhost server will stop. run the server again using the command npm run dev. Well, I can't see the new image, but our code is correct, so reload the page. And there you have it. We displayed the image using an online link. Next, we will do masking of an image. For masking, we will need two images, one base image and one mask image. To achieve masking, we need to write some CSS code. You can write custom CSS code in Next.js as well. Simply add the property name variable, which I have included in this div, image-mask-container. Later, we will write the CSS code for this. To mask the image, you need to add the following code to your project code. Now we are all set, I think. Let's test the project. Okay, I got an error. I made a type error when specifying the path of the mask image. So let's fix this. Okay, all set. You can see how masking is done here. It's not perfect, but you can use it in your own project in a more elegant way. In this video, we saw how to display an image from local storage, then we saw how to display an image from an online link, then at last we saw how to mask an image. All of these using the Next.js 13. That's it for this video. Share your thoughts in the comment section or follow me on my social media handles. The links are down below in the description. Thanks for watching and see you in the next Next.js video.